Hello, thank you for attending our session here at Universe on Advanced Authentication. My name is Kevin Pryor. I'm a software enterprise architect, and I'll be conducting today's session. So in our session today, we're going to cover what we offer for advanced authentication. There's a lot of different pieces there. How easy it is to use with your VPN. We'll actually go through and set that up and use it with advanced authentication. And then how easy it is to add to your computer login. So what does advanced authentication provide? You can quickly and easily add multi-factor to SAML, OpenID, and OAuth2. We can also easily connect to your LDAP directories as well as Azure via SKIN. Today we will show the radius where you can quickly integrate with your VPN solution to add multi-factor and further secure your internal network access. If you happen to use a mainframe, we can add multi-factor here as well. There's a few solutions that we have that are easily adapted to advanced authentication. We also provide a few plugins to help support with things like IIS and ADFS. If you're using those, also note that we do support Kerberos. If you want to further customize advanced authentication, the support for REST APIs and our SDK are also available. Here we have a high-level overview of all that advanced authentication has to offer. I will let you browse through these on your own. Please note that we have many methods to select from. You can also chain these together as well, meaning that to be successful for an authentication, you might require biometric, then smartphone, and Bluetooth, of which all must be successful to proceed. You have the option of how you want to use for your needs. There are many features included as well as the option to use on clients, for authentication, as well as our risk service. So in the initial configuration, what we have is we've already got our advanced authentication SaaS tenant is set up, meaning that that was provisioned. I do have our cloud bridge for the LDAP users already installed. We also have a VPN server that's installed that is currently using LDAP, as many of you are probably as well. And then we're going to go through all the different configuration options here within the admin portal. So the main thing that you need to look at here are chains, the events, and policies. So let's go through and look at the VPN with advanced authentication. What we're going to demonstrate is a user logging into a workstation the way that they would typically do, log into the VPN as they would do today. Then we'll go through and we will configure the VPN server for Radius. Then we'll configure advanced authentication for Radius. And finally, we use advanced authentication with the VPN login using a smartphone. So let's get started. Here, we're going to go ahead and basically log into the workstation as normal. This does already have the advanced authentication client installed. Here, it's prompting for our password, so we'll just enter in our LDAP password to get authenticated. And as you see here, I'm getting logged in. So once we're logged in, we've actually gotten here at the desktop. We can now go ahead and actually log into the VPN client. So here we'll simply right mouse click. We'll go up, we'll select that, and click on connect. We've got our username. We'll now go ahead and just provide our LDAP password. And again, this is basically the client the way that it is today for your end users. Now, if you notice here in the system tray, you can see that the icon is changing, and now we've gotten connected. Now let's go ahead here and we'll click on the icon here and we'll disconnect. And now let's go to the server and look at Radius server. So in this case here, you can see that we do have users authenticating via LDAP. So to enable this with advanced authentication is very easy. We'll simply go to Radius. Right? We've already got PAP selected. We're then going to provide the host name or the IP address. In this case here, we have our NPS server and our shared secret that's going to be used. We'll select Use Radius. Now we'll update the running server. So at this point here, any authentications that come in are going to be going through Radius. And again, we can validate that because now we see that this has changed to Radius. In advanced authentication, if we simply now go down to our policies, and then we'll go down and we'll select our Radius options. And we'll scroll to the bottom. And here for the clients, what we're going to do is we're going to add our VPN. So this is going to be the IP address of our VPN server that we were just on. We can provide it now a descriptive name. And then what we'll do is we'll provide the secret that was used on the Radius server. So we'll type that in, confirm it, then we'll save the client information, and then we'll save our changes. Now what we'll do is we'll go to chains and we'll create a new chain. So you can name these whatever you want, but for our demonstration, I'll use VPN-smartphone. And now on the left, what we'll do is we'll select the methods that are going to be used, and that's going to be our LDAP password and smartphone. Understand that these are chained together. Next, what we'll do is we'll actually assign it to a group of users, and in this case, we have our VPN users group. So we'll go ahead and we'll save that. Next, we'll go to our events, and we'll go down to our Radius server. You want to check, verify that it's enabled. Now we'll go ahead and we'll select the chain that we had just created, and we'll save that. So fairly simple to do. Let's go back to our workstation now, and here I'm showing my phone. So you can actually see what this looks like. So again, we'll simply go to the VPN like we did before, provide our LDAP password, press enter. And now you'll notice here on my phone that we see authentication required. So I can go ahead and tap that. It is protected by either biometric or face. And then what you'll see here is an accept decline. So here we'll go ahead and we'll click on accept. And again, if you look at the icon here in the system tray, you'll see that now we're going through and we're connecting. And now we have the message that we've connected. So in just a couple of minutes, we've gone through to set up our VPN with advanced authentication using two-factor. Now, one other question that might come up is, hey, well, what if I only want users in a certain area? We support geo zones as well, and that's actually configured under our methods and then smartphone. And I already have three geo zones that are already configured. I have zone one that currently I'm not in. So again, this is just using Google Maps, and I've drawn out an area where I'm not located. You can also go in and actually go around a city, select just that city if you want. You can actually get down to a building as well. And lastly here, what I've got in our example is just the state of Texas, and that's where I'm currently located. So now that we have those in place, we'll go ahead now and we'll look at our event for the Radius server. Notice here we have an option for geofencing that's off. I'll now turn that on, and I'll select zone one that I'm not in. We'll go ahead and we'll save this. And now we'll go back to our workstation, and we'll go through this process again. So again, we'll click connect. Provide our password, press enter, and again, notice we have the authentication required. And what I want you to realize here is that we're going through on the smartphone and we're validating, yeah, this is me, all right, accept it. And now what's happening in the background is it's actually looking at the geo services and it sees that we're not in that zone. So since we're not in there, it's not going to connect us. Right? And you can see that here, because again, the other times that we've gone through, we connect to it right away. So now let's go back, and now what we'll do is we'll choose the state. Right? And we'll go ahead and we'll click save here. And again, go back to the workstation. We'll go through that process again. Go ahead and we'll select connect. Provide our password. Again, we have the authentication required. We can go ahead and click accept. And now if you look at the system tray icon, again, you'll see now that we're connecting. Right? So again, since we are in that geo zone, now that connection has been established. So now we'll go ahead and we'll disconnect. Right? And we can go through and continue on here. So as you see, setting up the VPN was very easy to do. We had that set up in just a couple of minutes, and we were able to implement it. Now let's talk about the workstation login with advanced authentication. Right? Our workstation client is already installed and configured, and what we're going to do is we're going to set it up to log in using our smartphone first, then LDAP password. Right? And yes, we are adding multi-factor before the LDAP password. I like to recommend this to customers, for reasons being that if somebody does get somebody's LDAP password, they have to go through the two-factor before they can actually validate that. We also have the ability to not require an LDAP password at all, so I could do just the smartphone notification where I get the push notification. I'll then use my fingerprint, PIN, or face to unlock the app and then accept. So we're actually not providing an LDAP password. So to get this set up here, what we're going to do is we're going to go back here to our chains. We'll create a new chain. In this one here, we'll just call it smartphone plus LDAP. And now what we'll do is we'll go down under our methods here and we'll select smartphone first. So that will be the first method required. Once that's successful, we will then prompt for the LDAP password. Again, we can go ahead and assign this to a group of users. So here I've got a workstation MFA group set up. So I'll go ahead and select that so only those users are able to use it. We'll save it. Now what we need to do is go to the event and we're going to go to our Windows logon. And now we're going to add that chain, the smartphone plus LDAP. Geofence, if you notice here, there is an option, it's off, and we'll go ahead and we'll save that. Now if we go back to our Windows workstation and we go to log in, what you'll notice here is that once that is entered, we get prompted here for the smartphone first. We have to do the verification on our smartphone first. Once we accept this, we're then prompted for our LDAP password. So we'll go ahead and type in our LDAP password. Press enter. And at this point here, we are getting logged into our workstation. All right. So hopefully what you've seen demonstrated here is how easy it is to get this configured in your environment and actually get started with this. So here what we have is our product documentation page. We also have the product homepage as well as our software trials. Thank you very much for your time today. I hope this has been helpful. Have a great day.